From the unfriendliest city on earth, this is the Shreveport Report for June 23rd, 2016. Shreveport always has been, is, and may always be the unfriendliest city on earth. Never mind being unfriendly. What would you say if your neighbors did this to you? These are the organ donor gang. How dignified is that? The one on the left is the one that's riding the mini bike and the ATVs and the go-karts all the time. I call him the smiling gangster. Again, never mind unfriendly. What if the 9-year-old neighbor threw a rock at your house like this one does? And we can't prosecute 9-year-olds. That car is going 50. She just barely made it out of the way. She's watching her cell phone. We can see where they live. And you notice, didn't get out of the way of that car either. Or this one. So I call the police.
What's with the hood?
Oh, the car needs to cool down.
Needs to cool off?
Yeah.
Well, welcome to the other hood.
Okay.
I'm under constant attack. The gangsters up the street walk by and do obscene things to me, including showing their private parts. See the person standing on the porch right there?
Right.
Okay. Two people in that house just walked by and threw a rock. Mm. You can see it right there in front of the greenhouse.
Okay.
This is all on video. Okay. Which is going in my YouTube channel. So, that house, I don't know if you understand, but every weekend there's gunfire from that location.
Okay, but they didn't break anything with the rocks, right?
Right, but this is, I can't be outside without somebody attacking me for some reason. Verbally, obscene, you know. I need to do work down the street, you know. I'm friends with the owner next door. He owns the house on the corner and the one right here.
Yes, sir.
And I'm, you know, I need to clear the brush. There was a burglary right here 2 weeks ago because that house is... The next one down, not this one, the next one. But because that it's like a canyon there. So I'm going to clear the brush there. It's very strenuous. I'm 66 years old. It's not easy for me to do heavy yard work. But I can't be in my yard. I can't come and go without somebody accosting me, you know, verbally throwing things, threatening me, you know. So what I expect next is violence, okay, you know, either from me or from them. So we need to protect each other by, you know, just calming the F down. So the guy who just did the obscene gestures to me, you know, he's the one on the go-karts and the mini bikes. The 5205.
Okay.
Yeah. And he comes by and he smiles and he says obscene things with the little white boy. I call him their pet monkey, because that's what he is. He's their pet monkey. And you know, as soon as there's trouble, you know what's going to happen? They're going to sacrifice him.
Yeah.
Yeah, of course. So this is why I record everything. So, you know, it's protect me, it's protect you, it's protect them.
I'm going to make contact with them about the rock thing. You know, I don't know. You know,
this has been going on for 2 decades now. I can show you a pile of rocks on my porch that I pick up out of the yard. Okay, yeah. And, you know, if I'm out here and there are people walking by throwing rocks at me, I can shoot back.
If one hits you, okay to call us?
All I have
to... Has anyone ever hit you?
It's a reasonable fear of injury. That's all I need.
Okay.
And you can tell...
I would like you to call us before, you know, it gets to that
no,
point.
No, because it doesn't do any good.
I mean, you know...
Here you are, right. You know, 20 minutes later.
Okay.
And, you know, as soon as you leave, they'll come back and do it again. Because I called you. Because you're the enemy. Not my enemy,
right.
Their enemy.
Right.
Because they're the criminals.
Right.
Now, there was an older woman, I guess, I don't know if she's mother or sister or what. And she was like communicating with the gangsters, you know, high-fiving them and stuff. And then 5 minutes later, the rock gets thrown by a little girl with a yellow blouse, yellow shirt. But, you know, they're the ones, those kids are the ones illegally riding their bicycles in the street with their sisters and their friends on the handlebars,
right.
Which is going to end in disaster, you know? Yeah, we'll read about it in the paper.
Well,
9-year-old girl run over by anonymous...
You know, but you know, their parents know, so I mean, but I'm going to go down here and talk to
them. It's the parents who are empowering
right.
them.
Right.
Okay.
And you know, can't raise anybody else's kids.
This is third generation now,
right.
Okay? The little gangster boys down there, they're second generation. And they skirt the law. They're constantly pushing the envelope to see what they can get away with. Like 4-year-olds pulling on the drapes. You know, can I pull on this? You know, that's what they're doing. Is they're experimenting to see how much they can taunt me and get away with it. But as soon as they do something that threatens me, something really bad's going to happen. Okay? Those are shrubs. Well, I'm cutting the ones on the other side. They're all coming down. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Mr. Madison, you want his phone number? The telephone pole is the line. You have to be able to see over the fence. You're welcome. Yeah, that's real safe. To them.
Okay.
Is there a problem? I'm talking to you now. I live here. I live here. I don't have a problem. Well, who's getting smart now? I'm old enough to be your grandfather.
Say, man, my grandpa did, but I watch your motherfucking mouth. You hear me? Say something about my grandpa one more time.
I said, I'm old enough to be your grandfather.
Yeah, I'm old enough to whoop your fucking ass like I'm
See, you're real sociable. Sociopath.
What the fuck you just call me, bitch?
A sociopath.
Don't run, bitch.
I'm not a bitch. I'm not a bitch.
Look, man, I'm coming down here minding my own goddamn business. You keep
I didn't talk
to me, bitch, and I got something.
You're the one raising the ire. You're raising the ire. You're raising the ire. I'm a nice person.
First of all, you got me on YouTube on your videos not once, not twice, but several times. I never gave you permission for that.
Like right now, you're in the street. It's public property.
No.
Yep.
Yep. In the streets, government property. I'm not
public property.
What I'm saying is,
you're in public.
YouTube, man. I never gave you permission to put me there.
Like now. Like now. I didn't smart mouth you. You're the one with the smart mouth. No. You're lying now. Now you're lying. You're lying. You were just lying. I'm not lying. Good. Use it. Publish it. Publish it. Why do you have to be so antagonistic?
All I'm saying, man, watch out about my grandpa.
I didn't say anything about your grandpa. Your grandpa. He's your grandfather, by the way, not your grandpa.
Hey, that's my grandpa.
I said, no. You're obviously, and... You're obviously upset about nothing.
Yeah, that's okay.
Okay.
Is there a problem? I ain't no problem. I thought you said something to me. I'm talking to you now. You ain't gotta get smart with me, boy. I ain't the one. I don't know who you are.
I live here.
I never met you before, but you ain't gotta get smart with me.
I live here. I don't have a problem.
I'm not lying.
It's all right, buddy. I've got it recorded myself, man.
Good.
I said nothing to you. Publish I didn't it. Even say hey.
Publish it. Why do you have to be so antagonistic?
All I'm saying is, man, watch him out by my grandpa.
I didn't say anything about your grandpa.
I'm get you. That's not
your grandpa. He's your grandfather, by the way.
Hey, that's my grandpa. I'm coming, boy. You're going to learn that real quick. Don't correct me. I graduated from high school,
no,
nigga.
No.
Tell you that real quick, bitch.
You're obviously...
I'm telling you, man. Keep running your goddamn mouth,
you're obviously upset about nothing.
Hey, you see me running the other way.
I'm going out
of the way. Get down my damn yard.
Get out of my damn yard.
I'm not going to play.
We'll see about your yard.
This is the reason why I commented about not being safe. This clip is self-explanatory.
Yeah, that's real safe.
Glenn? Glenn? Say something?
To them.
Okay.
Is there a problem?
I ain't no problem. I thought you said something to me.
I'm talking to you now.
You ain't gotta get caught with me, boy. I ain't the one. I don't know who you are.
I live here.
I've never met you before, but
I live here.
You ain't gotta get caught with me.
I live here. I don't have a problem. Well, who's getting smart now? I'm old enough to be your grandfather.
Hey, man. Hey, my grandpa did it, so watch him go fuck him out. You hear me? Say something about my grandpa one more time.
I said, I'm old enough to be your grandfather.
Yeah, I'm old enough to whoop your fucking ass like I'm your grandfather, too.
Gee, you're real sociable. Sociopath.
What the fuck you just call me, bitch?
A sociopath.
Don't run, bitch.
I'm not a bitch. I'm not a bitch.
Look, man, I'm coming down here to mind my own goddamn business. You keep talking to me, bitch, and I got something.
You're the one raising the ire.
I'm telling you now.
You're raising
I got something for you.
You're raising the ire.
See, you don't realize
I'm a nice person.
All this shit, bro. Hey, first of all, you got me on YouTube, on your videos, not once, not twice, but several times. I never gave you permission for that
shit. Like right now, you're in the street as public property.
Nope.
Yep.
Government property. Yep. In the streets, government property. I'm not
public
on the
public property.
But what I'm saying is,
you got me
on YouTube, man. I never gave you permission to put me in the
street. Right now.
All right. It's cool. All I'm saying
is,
you ain't had no reason to sit there and smart mouth me.
I didn't smart mouth you. You're the one with the smart mouth.
Hey, man, did you get that on camera?
Oh, yeah.
Thank you so much. He already told my dear grandpa as soon as I walked past.
No. You're lying now. Now you're lying.
It's fine, because look. Hey, look, buddy. Look, you see this phone right here? It's a Galaxy Samsung 7.
You're lying.
Right
you were just lying.
It's fine. I got it recorded myself.
I'm not lying.
It's all right, buddy. I've got it recorded myself, man.
Good.
I said nothing to you.
Publish it.
I didn't even say hey.
Publish it. Why do you have to be so antagonistic?
All I'm saying is, man, watch him out by my grandpa.
I didn't say anything about your grandpa. He's your grandfather, by the way, not your grandpa.
Hey, that's my grandpa. I'm coming, boy. You're going to learn that real quick. Don't correct me.
I graduated
from my school, nigga.
No.
Tell you that real quick, bitch.
You're obviously...
I'm telling you, man. Keep
you're obviously upset about nothing.
You see me running the other way. I'm going out of the way.
Shreveport Police, number 28.
Hello, this is Jay Salsburg. I want the district supervisor to show up. ASAP.
What's going on?
I can't step outside my house without being threatened. So we're going to...
Who's threatening you?
The neighbors.
Okay, where's the neighbor at?
In the neighborhood. I need the district supervisor, please.
And what's your phone number? Okay, so the person is threatening you, sir. Do you know where they live or where they are?
Not exactly, but they're here all the time, so...
And they're there now?
They rode off. So we're going to have issues unless someone shows up and takes a report.
I'll let him know, sir.
Thank you.
How'd you like that display of intimidation? That guy was really cuckoo, right? And what's with you throwing rocks at my house? You, with the yellow shirt, throwing rocks at my house. Not good. I can't step out the door without somebody harassing me. I'm dragging this yard waste back to chop it up because the owner of the property there says I have permission to trim the hedge. Otherwise, we're going to get property standards involved. See, you see, this is why he was robbed. I have video of him being robbed. I submitted it to the community liaison officer, nothing happened. So he threatens me to stay out of his yard. I know it's never in his yard.
Okay.
I don't know if you understand property standards. You can't have shrubs above the fence line like these. These have to go. And the reason why he was robbed is because you can't see his house from the street. It's not in his yard, no.
So that piece of shrub is not his property?
No,
that's what you're saying?
No. So, I asked for the district supervisor.
That's me.
Okay. I was just threatened right here. See, what happens is I step outside, these guys SMS each other that I'm outside, and they all converge on me. I'm dragging this stuff back, and there's a white guy who comes by. I'm dragging this stuff back, and see the little boy there? I guess it's him. He's nearly run over by an SUV. He throws his bikes down and abandons it in the street, and I said, that's not safe. Mm-hmm. And the guy going by on his bicycle said, are you talking to me? Getting all, attitude. It's, mm-hmm. We have video of everything, so I'm not concerned about who said what. Uh-huh. But he's sociopathic, on the aggression, being aggressive, uh-huh. Toward me. So I just, you know. The gang members walked by earlier. I want to file a report on them. I have video of it, so you're going to get a copy, and we're going to go to court.
What they do? You haven't told me what anybody's done yet.
Calls me names, shoots me the bird, grabs his junk, you know, right here in front of my house. And it's back and forth all day long. Okay? I can't go down the street there because I'll be killed if I go down there. This house right here with the kids playing in the yard, you've been called over and over again for drive-by shootings, loud parties. You know, 7 cars showed up the other night, 7 of your cars, for I don't know what. And I'm sure they thought I phoned. I didn't. Somebody else did. Something else happened. Somebody passed out or the neighbors. So
was it this guy who threatened you or the gang?
No, some white guy. Now, as soon as you drove up, he ducked around the corner. I don't know if you noticed or not.
No,
I'll take these off.
For your address. So it wasn't this guy they're talking to. It was a white guy.
No. He said, you stay out of my yard. Well, I was never in his yard. Right. You know, people think that this is their yard. They're responsible for it, but people can walk by here because this is where the sidewalks. Yeah, right. Well, this is a bizarre truck. I don't know what the deal is with this truck. It's really bizarre. So it's just one thing. I literally cannot. The gang members come by, and if they see me, they act out, right? Intimidation, obscenities, profanity, you know. Well, the next step is violence. Hate crimes, calling me all kinds of hate. And, you know, I filed reports on it. I filed stalking reports on these guys. We need to do that again.
Okay. Well, I can get the officers to write your report, but how did the white guy threaten you? What did he say?
He's trying to pick a fight with me. So he's being combative.
Well, you got to tell me what you mean by combative. Is he cussing at you?
Yes.
You know, what's he saying?
Calling me names, saying that I'm saying stuff about his family, which I wasn't. I was having a conversation. I thought he was having a conversation. But he's being combative. I wasn't being combative.
When you say combative, just verbally or?
Yeah, wanted to hurt me. Yeah, threats.
Hurt you how? You got to be specific on a threat. A threat is I'm gonna kick your ass. That's
yes, he said that.
Mr. Salsburg, okay.
Several times.
He said he doesn't have a problem with you cutting limbs, just not on his side of that fence. So you're cutting on the other side because he said he had to drag those to the trash can. He said you're cutting on the other side of his residence, but
yes,
the shrub is in his yard. And you refuse to move
them. I did that this morning and I got tired, so I stopped and waited for the sun to come down a little bit.
I understand, but if you're going to cut on the opposite side, you have to move the shrub if they're in his yard. You have to move them.
Well, they weren't in his yard. They weren't in his yard.
Okay, well, he said it is.
He thinks the neutral ground is his yard. There he is. That's him. He threatened me.
He said this guy threatened him, but he hadn't got the
But they said he would call the kid racial slur.
No.
No, they said a few times.
No.
I said he said.
No. They think I might have said that because that's their hearing is not connected to their brain properly. Okay? Since I have multiple copies and video of everything that happened, you'll see that I didn't threaten or call anybody use any profanity or threaten anybody.
Jameson, go get me inside, the guy on the bike. Stop him and get his side.
The juvenile?
Yeah, the bike.
I don't think he's a juvenile.
So look, I understand everything you're saying, but if the tree limbs happen to fall in this man's yard, can you please just move him to the curb, move him out of his yard?
Well, I had, you know, a profound sinking spell because of heat exhaustion, so I waited till the sun got lower.
There's nothing wrong with that.
So, you know, I don't understand. him. Let's use him as an example. I have video of the burglary. Okay, I submitted it to the Bowman. Gave her the link to it. Okay, I told him, I went over there and I told him that I have video of the burglary. And now he behaves like this. So, you know, for the evidence to be used against the perpetrator, I have to testify. His attitude means that I don't testify, as far as I'm concerned.
We can't force you to do anything. It's just...
You know, that's my spending capital right there. You know, if he's not... The reason why he got burglarized is because he's living in that canyon with nobody across the street to see his house.
Right, but he has a landlord, and so he said he has to ask...
I know. Roger Christian, I used to work for him.
So he said he, you know...
Yeah, if he does anything, the landlord can end up evicting him.
But the landlord can't because it's property standards.
Well, that's when the landlord needs cited by property standards for the violation.
Guess what? Property standards doesn't give a flip.
Well, I mean, they'd have to cite him for it. And now, if you want to report for...
I'm not concerned with him. He's not the problem. The problem are the young people continually harassing me. The girl that threw the rock earlier is 9 years old, okay? And she was being escorted by an adult who is empowering her to do things like that.
Well, their parents, when I spoke with them, their parents went home, but there was an 18-year-old sister.
Yeah, okay, with the red shirt.
Okay, but I wasn't able to make contact with a parent.
Right.
The parent wasn't there, okay? But I did explain to them and I talked to them, okay, and they advised me that they would not come down here and throw rocks anymore. The little girl said she did throw rocks because you called her a racial slur.
No, I didn't. No,
not, you know,
I wasn't even outside
right.
when she did that.
And I understand, you know, I understand.
Yeah.
Yes.
And the parents are teaching them to do this. I swear.
You met her parent, her mom. But when she gets home,
I'm old enough to be her mother's grandfather.
I understand.
Okay. Yes, and so can the parents. This is the case. Now, we have multiple gunfires from this house right here.
The house that I visited earlier?
Yeah. Playing in the street at 2 o'clock in the morning. Children. Playing basketball at 2 o'clock in the morning. Yes. No, no. You know why? Because the street is 3,000 feet long. As soon as a car appears at the end, the rats are in their hole. This little girl here saw everything. She was standing right there with the white boy, white man.
Mr. Salsburg, we're getting different stories from a bunch of different people. So, I mean, we can write you an incident report about the gang members walking by your house, but we can't stop them from walking by your house, and we can't stop them from shooting you the bird because it falls under, you know, freedom of speech. I mean, I'll be happy to have somebody write you a report if you want one, but, I mean, they've got...
What about the man threatening to kick my ass, as quote, unquote?
That's what I'm saying. If you want a report, we'll do your report, but there's witnesses saying that that didn't happen. Said you were talking about his dead granddad.
No, I wasn't. No. No, all I said was I'm old enough to be your grandfather. Mm-hmm. And, you know, he was looking for a fight. That's what he's looking for.
Well, we're getting different stories from different people.
Well,
not just him.
The video doesn't lie.
Well, can you show us the video with audio?
Yes. Yes.
Show it to me.
It'll take a while.
Like how long a while?
Well, 15 minutes.
Yeah, if you want to call back, we'll come back and pick it up. I mean, if you want a report, I'll be happy to have these officers take your report.
Okay.
But to be able to prosecute anybody, we have to have some type of evidence showing that he made a verbal threat.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's quite clear that I have that.
But what did he say? Exactly what did he say?
Sir, I'm going to kick your ass. He was being combative.
Yeah, but when you say combative, you have to be able to describe to us what you mean by combative.
He was trying to egg me on to say something and misconstruing on purpose what I was saying.
Well, combative is not a verbal. Combative is
posturing to threatening language. That's combative.
You know, but like I said, if you got it on video, we'll be happy to look at it and go from there.
Oh yeah.
But we have to have something showing the threats because they have other witnesses who are saying that didn't happen.
Right. Well, the video and the audio doesn't lie.
Well, I mean, like I said, if you want to give them your information and exactly what happened to do the report, and we'll be happy to come back out and pick the video up.
Yeah.
And it's up
well,
to you.
Okay. The reason why I'm pressing the issue is because I had a long talk with Captain Willis this afternoon, and she said that I need to start filing charges.
Like I said, you show us the evidence of him threatening, we can do that. We can most certainly do that.
Yes.
You know, you'll have to go to court and testify.
But if you said something too, though, both of y'all can go. If it's vice versa, both of y'all.
Yeah, now if you said something that escalated it or something.
Yeah. After he threatened me a couple of times, I said, well, you're being sociopathic. That's the only thing that I said that was possibly offensive. That's it. I didn't use any profanity or any threatening language or any obscenities or making references to anybody he knows or his friends, his family, or anything like that. He was looking to fight.
Like I said, you show me that video and you want to press charges and it's on that video, we'll do it.
Okay, the little gang member up here at 5205 that keeps coming by and calling me racist names, what are we going to do about that? Today,
the problem is you have a lot of freedom of speech. You can take them to civil court and get peace bonds or restraining orders.
Okay, I respectfully disagree because I've been charged and convicted of using profanity right here where I'm standing. And an officer testified against me that wasn't even present when it happened because the neighbors filed charges against me.
They probably did it for disturbing the peace under what they
I was merely repeating what they were saying to me. Just
you know, I can't answer for cases in the past because I wasn't there.
Well,
I
mean, this is why I'm having trouble.
We're here to help you today.
I understand. This is why I'm having trouble with this, because what will happen if I follow through on this is retaliation.
And I understand that, and we're not trying to force you into anything you don't
sorry, you remind me, what about that YouTube page? They said,
yes.
They showing you got about
everything's going on YouTube.
But you don't think that brings retaliation towards you?
Only if they have something to worry about, right? If they're not doing anything wrong, nothing to worry about, right? But obviously they're doing stuff wrong. That's why they're upset. Because this is a culture of crime. I live in a neighborhood whose culture is crime.
What do you want? You want a police report? You want to think about it?
I'll bounce everything onto a CD. We'll use that as evidence.
Well, if you want to do that, you need to provide them all the information so they can do a police report.
Information? Well, they take the information from me verbally, right?
Right.
Yeah, fine.
They'll do it right now, and they'll write it up what you say.
It'll take me probably an hour to get the CD made.
Well, we'll do the report, and if you have it ready for us, if not, the next shift can pick it up and turn it in as evidence. I mean, but if you want to file a report, we need to do it
yes,
now.
Yes,
yes. And you're saying he threatened to kick your ass. Is
what yes. Him, right there. I can see him from here.
What's your name, sir?
Freeland, Freeland, Jay, Salsburg.
What's your first name?
Freeland.
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 Last name?
Salsburg.
And see, we're being watched by the organ donor gang.
We can't stop people from being outside. I mean, we can't do that.
As soon as you leave, they're going to come down here.
5333 Kent?
Yeah.
Date of birth?
10/11/49.
Phone number?
734-9106.
All right. Are you threatening to kick your ass?
Yes.
Positive, that's what he said.
Yes, more than once.
Who did that little girl had a witness?
In the white shirt. She was standing right there.
She was standing right there?
She was standing right there.
He said she was standing right there.
That's
what I thought. What she said? See?
That's what I thought.
This report number, and I'll write it up and get that video.
Get the video.
Call the dispatcher.
Just call dispatch like you did, and they'll send an officer out to pick it up.
Okay. I need to label it somehow, just my name and this report number. 16108969.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, just write that report number on it.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. He lives there. Of course, when he comes and goes, he always announces his comings and goings with his booming stereo. He's been doing that for years.
All right, well, when you get the video, let us know. And we'll go from there. Are you going to want to pursue charges, or you just want to report?
Yeah, that was way over the top. I didn't deserve that treatment.
All right, we'll get it done, and just let us know when you get it.
Look, two organ donors. Here they come at 40 miles an hour. Gee.
Hello, this is Jay Salsburg. An ATV just went by at about 40 miles an hour with a child on it. And it's, what, 10:30? So, you know, illegal vehicle, no lights, and after curfew.
I'm going to put that ticket out.
Okay, thank you.
This person doesn't deserve to be on my street. Call the coroner. Tell him to bring two body bags.
I'm trying to contact Captain Willis.
Good afternoon, Community Policing. How may I help you?
Hello, this is Jay Salsburg.
Okay.
I've talked to Captain Willis in the past. Is that possible now?
Hold on a second. Let me see if she's in. Hold on.
Okay. Hello?
Captain Willis, may I help you?
This is Jay Salsburg.
Yes.
Do you remember me?
I do.
I'm calling you out of desperation.
Okay, I'm listening.
There were two incidences today, never mind the traffic problems, but the gangsters up the street, I call them the Oregon Donor Gang, mm-hmm. Are getting more and more bold.
Okay, bold on doing what?
Walking by my house, making obscene gestures, dropping their pants.
Okay.
Showing themselves.
They showing their genitals?
I can't be sure because you know they're what they
do.
Did
you call the police to come out?
Oh yeah, they're cowards. They walk by, then they taunt me, and then they walk, then they continue on, then they. You know, so that they're out of reach.
Did you call for an officer to come out?
Yes.
And what happened?
Plus a young girl threw a rock.
Uh-huh.
Because I...
Threw a rock at what?
At my house. Now, what's going on is the gangsters empower the children to do this. The children think that, you know, by acting out, they can impress these young gangsters. Well, throwing rocks at me is not the way to do that. Mm-hmm. I don't care. I'm just saying that I can't be outside my house. I can't even be in my house without being taunted.
Okay.
Now, there was a go-kart going by today. Two kids were on it.
Uh-huh.
Last night, 11:30 at night, two kids.
Did you call the police?
Yes.
Okay. Did they come out?
Yeah. Okay. But it's too little too late.
Okay.
And we know who's doing this. It's the gangsters up the street.
But you have to make a report. You have to call the police number. And they have to come out and take a report. That's the problem. You have to make a report.
But I've done this over and over again.
But you have to, if they're doing what you say they're doing and you have them on camera.
Yeah.
You have to make a report and you have to let the officers see the people.
The officers are never going to see them do this. Never.
No, I say on your camera.
Well, I post the videos to the mayor every day.
Mm-hmm.
That's all I can do. I mean,
no, I didn't say the mayor. I said the police officers that comes out to your house and talk to you. Can't you show them the video on your...
They'll have to go to my YouTube channel. It's too difficult to carry a computer out to them to show them the stuff.
Oh, okay, especially, so they can't come in your house.
Especially in the daytime. Well, I don't care, but
you can come inside and show them.
Yeah, I have hundreds of videos of this.
No. Listen to what I'm saying. When a crime is being committed and you call the police out and you can identify them and you say they live at this address right here down the street, these are the people that did it, you take the officers in and show them your video. They arrest them based on what you said and the video. They write a report and then you go to court on it.
Yeah, I wish that would happen, but I filed reports for stalking, and nothing seems to happen.
No, well, you gotta show the officers on your video, and you are the witness that this is occurring to you.
Okay, well, let's do that now.
I can't do that. You need to call the police and have them come out there. You need to call the regular police number and have an officer come to your house and make a police report and show them on your video that this person right here lives at this house and this is the person that committed a crime.
Mm-hmm.
If it's a crime that was committed, the officer will write a report and the officer will make the arrest if they have enough probable cause.
Okay.
So that's how that works.
Okay, I'll compile the video and then I'll phone it in.
Okay.
And I'll have the officer come in the house and see the video.
Okay, and you can point out the house that these people live at, right?
Yes.
And that you can see them clearly, who they are.
Yes.
Did you say broke your window?
No.
Oh, okay. What did they exactly say?
The rock was thrown by a little girl. Now,
okay, did she damage your property?
No, but I have piles of rocks in my yard from this.
Okay.
Okay, this is an ongoing thing. This has been going on for 2 decades.
Okay.
Okay, I'm tired of it.
Okay.
Being taunted.
You can't do nothing about in the past decade ago.
I know, but
talk
it's
about the now.
It's a culture of crime. Now, the girl lives at this house 3 doors up.
Uh-huh.
There's been drive-by shootings from there. Every weekend, there's giant parties.
No, we haven't had any drive-by shootings on your street.
Oh, yeah.
Every weekend.
I report it to the mayor every day.
Well, nobody calls the police.
Yes, I did. I called.
On a drive-by shooting.
Yes.
Drive-by shooting.
Yes. Yes.
Where did it occur at? You got it on video?
Yes.
So you got a drive-by shooting where they shot at your house or they shot at
No, no. They're shooting down the street.
And you got it on video.
Yes. I have several of them. Yes.
Every day somebody's driving by shooting.
No, every day there's a crime to report.
No.
Right in front of my house. That's one of them.
Okay.
I'm being specific.
Okay. When a crime is being committed, you need to call the police to come out.
I do.
Okay. When a crime is being committed.
Yeah.
So if a crime has been committed on you today, call the police, give them a copy. If you can make them a copy of the video.
How? What are they going to do with, what do I give to them? How?
Don't you have a CD? What are you recording it on?
It's going to YouTube.
No. Do you have a camera?
It's digital.
Okay. Do you have a CD that you can put it on? Can you copy it to a CD? Because you're going to have to bring proof to court.
Yeah.
You're going to have to put a judge.
Yeah, it's very tedious.
Oh, well, we got to have the proof. You have to have probable cause. You got to have probable cause for an arrest.
Okay.
You
got
to have probable cause for it to go to court and for a judge to make a decision on it.
Okay, I can do that. And this is ongoing. I mean, every time I call, the police drive by, mm-hmm. something happens to me because they think that I'm calling.
Now, okay, well, either you're going to be a witness or you're not.
No, that's not it. That's not it. When other people call, mm-hmm. they blame it on me.
Okay, let's forget that. Everything okay. that's happening to you.
Do you have to understand? I've gone to court 40 times.
Okay.
In the
and
past.
What has happened in the past?
Nothing.
So the judge don't do nothing with it.
No, I was charged. See what happened? Now you don't understand. When I charge somebody, the neighbors get together and charge me falsely, and I'm dragged through court over and over again. No, I get subpoenaed. I don't get arrested. I get subpoenaed.
Okay.
I've been arrested for false charges too.
Okay.
Oh yeah.
Okay. Well, I can't do nothing about past stuff. But what I'm telling you now, if a crime is being committed, and it's being committed on you, and you can identify these people, and you can give us a copy of your video, you can show the officers, but you're going to have to give them a copy so they can have it for the file for it to go to court so a judge can look at it. That's the probable cause. The proof is the probable cause is your CD where you recorded somebody. We can't arrest them for mean mugging you. We can't arrest them for mm-hmm. walking by. But if they've taken off all their clothes and they're showing body parts, then they can be arrested for that.
Yeah. It's,
but you are going to be the witness. You have to right. be the court.
Right. Now, someone's been arrested. It was 15 years ago from
well,
the same house.
Let's not talk about 15 years ago. Let's not talk about that. Let's talk about today and now.
It's a continuous pattern of harassment.
But I understand what you're saying, but we're not talking about we got to talk about what's going on now. What's going on
it's
today.
It's the relatives. It's like the parents of the kids that are doing this uh-huh. have been arrested before for doing the same thing.
Okay. We still, but they can be arrested again.
It doesn't stop them.
Well,
I look.
I don't know what else to do this, other this, than to follow the letter of the law.
Okay. I'm now 66 years old.
Okay.
This is elder abuse.
Okay. I don't know what to tell you other than to follow the letter of the law.
Yes.
It goes in both directions. So I've told you what you need to do. The number is 673-7300.
Yeah, I know.
The person on the phone is the number three.
Well, you need...
If you feel like that you are being harassed, you have a right to make a police report. And the same way for your neighbors, if they feel like they're being harassed, they have a right to make a police report.
No, I don't harass anyone.
We can't stop people from making police reports.
Right, yeah.
But I've
actually been charged with crimes when I wasn't even in the state.
I understand all of that. So I don't know anything about you being charged with stuff while you weren't living in Shreveport. Okay? I don't know anything about that. What I do know is that if somebody was harassing me and they were trying to hurt me, I'm going to call the police.
Well, I do, but nothing happens.
Okay. Well, I don't know.
It's like, I'll talk to him. Well, it doesn't do anything.
Okay. Well, call the police. I'm going to get off the phone with you. Call the police. And maybe they will come out and take a report, and you can show them who's the person that threw rocks at you, okay? And they can make an arrest if they attempted to hit you with rocks.
Hit my house.
If they are over the age of 10.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah, it does. We can't take nobody under the age of 10 to jail.
Okay.
Yeah,
what if the sister or the parent was standing there with them?
I'm not there. Show the officers. I can't
okay.
guess. I can't. Yeah. I can't go on what if.
Right.
I have to go on things that are occurring.
Okay.
You need to call the police to make a report. Okay.
Okay. That's one thing. What are we going to do about these harassing?
Sir, call the police. Have them to come out
no,
and make a report.
No, you don't get it. Oh, wait a minute. Just let me say something. These characters with these giant cars with the giant pipes and the giant stereos. They come by and they rev their engines just for my benefit.
Okay. I'm not out there, all right? By the time we get there, I'm sure they're gone.
It's the same six or eight different cars.
We have ran operations on your street. We have sit over there on your street. But we have to move around also to other places that's calling just like you. They call and they want the same police and the same protection that you're asking for. So we can't just sit on your street. We have to go all over. So, but you can call the police when it's going on, and they can come out there and look for those cars.
If I was calling about everything that happened, we would be on the phone all the time.
Okay. Well, you'll be on the phone with the dispatcher. So,
that's what I mean.
I'm giving you what I would do if these things were happening to me.
It would mean literally that I have to call 10 times an hour.
That
reflects very poorly.
It does.
Very poorly on the neighborhood and the community.
It does. But if it's happening, that's one thing. If it's not, that's another thing.
Well, it's all on video. I post it every day.
But, sir, if they're playing loud music and the officers catch them, they get citations.
But that's not, they are not going to catch them. That's the problem.
We have ran radar.
That doesn't do any good.
We have ran radar. We have sit over there to listen for loud music.
You're not going to catch them.
Okay.
You're not going to catch them that way. You can't. Conventional methods are not working.
Well, we don't have no
You need unconventional methods.
We don't have no other way to catch them.
Yes, you do. Yes, you do.
Okay, I'm going to let you go, and you need to call the police, okay?
Okay.
I have new next-door neighbors. I'm talking about the neighborhood with them. When the smiling organ donor gangster rides by. He rides through the neighborhood day after day with impunity. Suicidal and smiling. Never mind his rancid racism.
This is Jay Salsburg. If an officer can roll into the neighborhood, we'll catch the mini bike.
Okay.
He's in the 2200 block of Morningside, across the street from me.
Okay, we'll get in. Did you need to be contacted or no?
Yeah, let's do that.
Okay.
Thank you.
And you said 5233?
5333.
No one showed up or contacted me. From the unfriendliest city on earth, this is the Shreveport Report for June 23rd. 2016. Shreveport always has been, is, and may always be the unfriendliest city on earth.